Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. We praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, send blessing and salutations upon Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We ask Allah to bless every single one of us and grant us goodness. First of all, let us thanks to Allah, the Almighty, the Glorious. Because of His blessing, we are able to come here to join in English meeting to discuss about the legalizing weed. So, gentlemen, good morning. Okay, the honorable people, for all my beloved students, our discussion for today is about legalizing weed. So there are two groups here. For the first group is the poor groups. They will explain to us about the benefits by legalizing weed. And for the second group is contra groups. They will explain to us and inform to us the dangers if the government legalizing weed. And then now I will read one by one the agenda for today. That are, the first season is opening, that what I do now as a moderator. And the second season is the explanation from the pro groups. They will tell to us about the benefit by legalizing weed. After that, there is a Q&A season, or a quiz and answer season. So for the country group, you should give some questions for the pro groups. And after that, the third season is the explanation from the counter groups. They will tell to us and explain to us about the dangers if the government's legalizing weed. True? And then the last agenda is closing season. So I would like to close our discussion for today. So let's start our discussion today by saying ha, Bismillah together, Basmalah together. Gentlemen, then for the first explanation from the poor groups, Alonza Narasadrika as a leader of the poor groups, they will tell us about the benefit by legalizing weed. So Alonza, with the member, time is yours.
Yes, thank you very much, Mr. Ibrahim, for the introduction of the topic. My name is Alonza Narasadrika, and we will, and me and my member will discuss about the legalization of weed. But before that, let me introduce my member. There is Zaki, Nas, Okto, Jafar, and lastly Farhan. And here I'm gonna explain what weed really is. Weed, or we can call it marijuana, is a psychoactive recreational drugs in use of religion, in use of religious and spiritual purpose, and the medical ailment. And there is more benefit of it. And we will start from Zaki that will explain from the health section. Time is yours, Zaki.
Okay, thank you very much, Alonza. And here I have some benefit from health section to explain. And here I have some point of it. The first point is to prevent glaucoma. The second point is to increase the capacity of lung. And the last point is to heal the nauseous. And based on research on the doctor to do the patient from to do the patient when given marijuana. The patient will have chronic pain, experience an improvement in their condition from before. In fact, patient with severe intestinal inflammation begin to eat again. Okay, thank you.
Thank you very much, Zaki. That's right, there is many more, I believe, from the health section, but the matter of time didn't help us from it. Then we will move to our comrades Nas that will explain about weed's factor in economical section. Time and place is yours, Nas.
Thank you very much, Alonza. So here, I will bring you the benefits for the weed in economic section. According to RCG economic study, the legalization of recreational marijuana creates 6,206 new full-time jobs in retail and production of marijuana, and generates a total labor income for $260,732,000. Thank you.
Thank you, Nas. That is from the economical section. And there is more of it because there are some countries that already legalized weed, and here is their economical kind of condition. Octo, time and place is yours.
My pleasure, Alonso. Here we are the benefit of countries that legalize weed economically. And we have Germany saving approximately 4.7 million euro and also create about 27,000 new jobs. Then we have Canada earned economical growth 1.1 million euro, million US dollar. And we have end profit income tax revenue about 400 million US dollar. And also California scooping 345 million US dollar from income tax. And its government are predicting it will achieve the number of 643 million US dollar. Thank you.
We see that many benefits that claim for the weeds itself in economical section in many countries. And lastly, Ja'far will mention direction from the United Nations and also their activists in weeds legalization. Ja'far, time and place is yours.
Okay, thank you very much, Alonza. And at this year, United Nations has legalized the weed for the medical plant and medicine. And the decision is voted by Commission on Narcotic Drugs with 27 nations was agree with the decision of legalizing the weed and in an economical profit of million US dollar. And managing director at cannabis consulting firm Global C, Jessica Steinberg, said that this does not mean that legalization will occur worldwide. However, this could be a defining moment.
Alhamdulillah, thank you to my teacher and all member of the team. The conclusion is of all statements we have on the past was weed is very beneficial in both of health section and economical section. Both of section that has their own benefits itself, and there is much more, I believe. For the next section is Q&A section. So for the contra group, which is not agree, give us two questions if you have. We will try to answer it in our ability. Thank you very much.
Okay, my name is Hijlal. I have a question for your team. The first question is, who will be responsible if there's abuse marijuana? And the second, how if people doesn't follow the regulation for marijuana consumption? Thank you.
Thank you for the question. Here I will answer the first question. The question is, who will be responsible if there's marijuana? The answer is, the one who will be responsible about the legalization of marijuana is the BNN. Thank you.
And for the second answer is, we will capture and apply for them the rehabilitation, also the education for using the weeds properly. Thank you very much.
Okay, thank you for the poor groups. That is really excellent explanation from the poor groups. They explained to us about the benefit by legalizing weeds. So we're gonna change the next session is about the dangers if the government's legalizing weeds. So for the counter groups, Yusuf, as a leader with the member, will explain to us about the dangers or the bad effects if the government's legalizing weeds. Okay, time is yours, Yusuf.
Okay, thank you for the pro teams and for our teacher. My name is Muhammad Yusuf, or you can call me Yusuf. I'm the leader of this group. We are the contract group for the legalization of marijuana. First of all, let me introduce my member. Starting from here, we have Fakih, then Amar, Ijlal, Irgi, and last Rafli. We are the contract group for the legalization of marijuana. Why? Because marijuana have a lot of bad effects that we have to consider about it. The legalization of marijuana cannot be underestimated because it has a lot of bad effects. First, our government has decided that marijuana is illegal in our country. Marijuana also one of the variety of narcotic psychoactive that has a lot of bad effects. And our society is not ready for the legalization of marijuana because our education is not well spreaded. The legalization of marijuana has to be along with the equality of education in every city in Indonesia, or there will be a lot of abuse using marijuana not as a medicine. There are more reasons why we have to reject the legalization of marijuana. But before that, we have to know what is the contents of marijuana. My friend Fakih will explain the contents of marijuana.
According to the Indonesian National Narcotic Agency, or BNN, marijuana that grows in Indonesia is different from that which grow in Europe or America. BNN state the research result, the psychoactive substance content of marijuana, or THC, which grow in Indonesia is high, reaching 18%. Meanwhile, the potential non-psychoactive substance as medicinal ingredient, CBD, is only 1%. BNN also explained that marijuana used for treatment. Status epilepsy is the result of genetic engineering with high CBD content and low THC. Thank you.
Thanks for Key for the information. And as we all know, marijuana have two bad effects for our body, for our physical health and for our mental health. And the next is Amar. Amar will explain to us about the bad effects of using marijuana for our physical health.
Okay. The U.S. Food and Drug Administration, or FDA, still doesn't consider marijuana safe or effective in any medical condition. Although cannabidiol, a substance found in marijuana, receive approval as a treatment for some types of epilepsy in 2018. The long-term effect of marijuana use depend on how and how often it is used, as well as age and how much it is used. Some of the most common effect of marijuana on physical health include: 1. Chance getting bronchitis when smoking marijuana. 2. Throat become plump when smoking marijuana. 3. Lung irritation. Thank you.
Thanks, Amar, for the bad effects of using marijuana for our physical health. And the next is Ijal. Ijal will explain to us about the bad effects using marijuana for our mental health. Time and place is yours.
Okay, I will explain for mental health. The following are the most common effects suffered by marijuana users. First effect is appetite and thirst increase or decrease. Second, symptom of depression. Third, anxiety symptoms increase or decrease. The fourth is bad judgment, difficulty in thinking clearly, and problem with memory. Thank you.
Thanks, Ijal and Amar, for the explanation about the bad effects of using marijuana for our physical and mental health. And next is Irgi. Irgi will explain about the dangers using marijuana and the damage causes of using marijuana for our organs.
There are a few human organs that may affect the cause of marijuana. First, brain. When you use too much marijuana, it will interfere with your ability to think. You can also lose memory to inhibit brain function. This is evidenced by certain structural changes in your brain using marijuana in the long term. Second, eat lung. In fact, the tar content in marijuana is almost 3 times higher than tobacco tar in cigarettes. The smoke produced from burning cigarette. The smoke produced from marijuana also has a much higher content of cancer-causing substances than ordinary cigarette smoke. As a result, the risk of lung cancer can increase, especially if you use marijuana for a long time.
Thanks, Irgi, for the explanation. And the last, as a good Muslim, we have to obey our religion, Muslim Islam. We have to obey all the regulations in Al-Quran and As-Sunnah. My friend Rafli will explain the point of view for Islam of using marijuana.
Last but not least, marijuana also prohibited in our religion. As a verse that we used to hear came from Surah Al-A'raf, verse 157, that said, وَيُحِلُّ لَهُمُ الطَّيِّبَاتُ وَيُحَرِّمُ عَلَيْهِمُ الْخَبَائِثُ and lawful for them everything that is good and forbid for them everything that is bad. As what we know, marijuana has a lot of bad effect, especially for our body. Therefore, Islam forbids us to consume and use marijuana. As a good Muslim, we have to obey this rule for our own good in this world and in the afterlife. Thank you.
Thank you for all my groups that have mentioned all the bad effects of using marijuana. And the last session is question and answer. Me and my group will try to answer. If from the pros team have question, we'll give you two question.
Thank you very much. So here we are, the two questions. The first question is, I have told you the benefits of the marijuana itself. So the question is, do you really reject it? The second question is, can you mention the alternative of weeds that can make the same benefits? Thank you very much.
Thank you for Alonza for the question. I will try to answer the first question. Why are we still rejecting the legalization of marijuana? From all the data that we have, marijuana, the conclusion of this discussion is marijuana has higher bad effects than the benefits. That's why we still rejecting the legalization of marijuana. Thank you.
Okay, I will answer the second question. Find other herbs that safer than marijuana, like black seeds, or we call it habatus sauda. Thank you very much.
Okay, thank you for the contact groups. Good explanations from the contact groups. So, alhamdulillah, gentlemen, finally we are come to the last agenda, closing seasons. So I would like to say thanks again for the leader for the four groups, Alonza Narasadrika with the members, and for the corner groups, Yusuf and the members, and all of the active participants for today. So the conclusion that I make some notes here for our discussion today. So legalizing weed is the topic of our discussion for today. Because of what we discussed today, we become to know that legalizing weed happened in another country and help their economic sector and help people in the medical sector. But we have to back to the obligation from our governments that weed or marijuana is the forbidden thing to consume for our society or our citizen in Indonesia. As we all know, now from contra group Fakis said that according to the Indonesian National Narcotic Agency or BNN, marijuana that grows in Indonesia is different from that which grows in Europe or America, which grows in Indonesia is higher, reaching 18% than those countries. That means the composition between the weeds in Indonesia and the weeds in those countries is different. As we all know, the majority of people in Indonesia are Muslim. So we all agree that weed is bad for Muslims. Even if that was good for the medical sector, but we can't be looking for another medicine without weed. Thank you. Okay, thank you so much. That's all is our discussion today. Let's say alhamdulillah together. Hopefully our discussion today will give benefit for us and give benefit for other people out there. And thank you for your attention. See you later. Let's close our discussion with doa kafaratul majlis. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.